Now, a price is the quantity of payments or compensation given by one party to the another in return for a unit of purchase of good or services. Now, the term for this price, you know, it's differential, the terms which we use. Usually, in business, we say, what is the price of a good? Usually. But the price has its own term, you can say, with reference to different goods purchased or services as such. If you have the agents, okay, who on behalf of the clientele works as an intermediary, we say whatever you pay them in return, okay, for the services rendered by them, we say it's a commission, isn't it? So commissions. So instead of price, we say commission given. What is your commission? That is what is the question. If suppose we rent out certain facility, maybe a house or a store, then the term we use for this price is rent. Similarly, the dealers, the distributors, they receive the benefit, okay, from the companies. In terms of price, of course, it is known as the margin. It's the margin given to the dealers or the distributors. Similarly, the price benefit transferred to the customers, we say it's the discount. Discounts availed. In monetary terms, these are the discounts. So here, or in case of insurance, we pay the premium. So so here the price, the terms, they vary with the change in the references which we use in day-to-day context. Now, as far as the rule of pricing is considered, okay, the basic thing, the businesses, any businessman starts a business with the basic motive of gaining the profits. So, here, the basic purpose of starting the business is gaining the profits. It is one of the very important element in the marketing mix, which generates the revenues. And these revenues are further used as the inputs. So, here, unless and until this price is there, an important consideration, the business is, they don't come to know about the performance, about their status, where they are. Now here, any business, it takes into consideration the cost of production, the first and foremost. In addition to certain margin, okay, certain profit margin, and then decides the end price. Now, price communicates also the quality. Now, many of you, when you visit the shops, when you buy the offers, the products, I mean. So, anything which you buy, apart from the contents, apart from maybe the ingredients, you also look for the price. Now, why do you look for the price? Many a times, this price communicates the benchmark of quality. So here you come to know about the ingredients. Many times these ingredients don't give a clear picture about the performance aspect or the functionality aspect of that product. That's why many a times you just have a glance at the price. This price, looking at the price, you come to know the value of the good. Now, this value is in terms of its performance, which is the reflection of the quality of that product. That's why we say price communicates the quality. So, whenever you just take the name of specific brands, you associate it with the price. Now, see here, how the terms are interlinked. Price, a particular segment, the quality, and the pricing. All these things, they match together. They go hand in hand together. And these perceptions, the customer starts developing their own perceptions regarding these attributes or features. This price also attaches value. Now, value in terms of what? That is the additional benefits with the customers they may be availing by purchasing that particular product or the offering or rendering the services. Price reflects the type of customer. So, as I said, that the purchasing power or the affordability of the customer gives a clear-cut idea of the income status of the customer, to which segment the customer belongs. So somewhere price is a reflection of the type of customers, or we directly can link it with the segmentation in the monetary terms. Price sets a benchmark for categorization of products. Now, when we say that when we bifurcate the products, so here price is one of the basic attribute which is helpful in categorization of different products. Lower level, medium level, top level, or higher level. So as price is a reflection of a type of customer, it also bifurcates this category of different products. Similarly, price and sales volume, the two together decide the revenue. Now, when the prices are too high, suppose the company has set a price at a very higher level, in that case, the margin is more. Though the market share or penetration is very low, the profit would be more. That is one thing. Second thing, if the prices are moderate or low and they have more customers, which builds up more volume, then also the outcome is the revenue generation here. So these were some of the role of the pricing. P, that is pricing tool of the marketing mix. Now the next is importance of pricing. Now pricing is one of the flexible element of marketing mix. Flexible. So here, if we take the first P, that is the product. If you want to think of altering a product, if you want to introduce a new product, if you want to introduce a new flanker product, in that case, the company requires much time. It has to decide about the components which go into it. It has to decide about research and development, about the need of the customers. If we take into consideration the distribution channel, the place attribute, there again the company has to take up with the brainstorming session. If we consider the advertising or the promotional part, there also the company has to give a thought. Now, as far as this pricing is considered, it is much more flexible, we say, because here many a times these prices are guided by the government norms. So if that particular offering comes into the category where the prices are regulated by the government, then there is no say for the service provider or the manufacturer. They have to vary the prices according to the government norms, whatever the government decides. Suppose if the competitor comes up with certain different strategy as far as this pricing is considered. So here, the company can think of coping up with the competitor. Maybe they can give certain discounts in pricing. Maybe they can reduce the price a bit. They can increase the price. So here, as far as this aspect is considered, there is flexibility which the company gets as compared to the other means. It is an internal component. While in case of advertising, promotion, distribution channel, the factors are influenced by the external environment. As far as the first P product is considered, according to the demand of the customers, that is the one aspect of the external environment. And it is into the hands of the company. But it requires a lot of time as well as the revenues. When the company thinks about this introduction of a new product or starting up of a new product line. Now here, right level of pricing is important. The pricing should be appropriate. It should not be less. If it is less, then the company is losing the profits, the revenues. If it is more, the company will lose the customers to the competitors. So here, looking into the scene of the market by taking into consideration the segment to which a particular product is offered, that should be taken into consideration. Which category of product it is, whether it's a convenient good, whether it is a emergency good, whether it is into a luxurious good, depending upon that, the prices have to be decided. Price creates first impression. So here this is more valid in terms of luxurious goods or prestigious goods. As soon as the customer comes to know about the pricing, somewhere he is mapping this pricing with the attributes of the product, the features, the benefits, and to whom that product is meant, that is segment, to which segment. That is what is constantly going on in the mind of the customers. That's why we say price creates the first impression. Vital element of sales promotion. So price is one of the important element of sales promotion. Sales promotion, maybe you are giving some discounts, offers. There are many offers with the companies. They come up with the different schemes, like 1+1 free, or maybe in the same price you get the extra amount, the increase in the volume. So this pricing plays a very important role. This message is spread through the sales promotion activities. And the customer always would like to take opportunity here. They would like to take the benefit of these schemes. Now, many of the online shopping websites like Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, they are using this pricing as one of the important attribute in sales promotion. You might have, many of you might have received the messages, the popping up of messages. So that is what is the pushing the sales promotion activity. Price also marks the differentiation of products. Now here, suppose if a particular good is a convenience good on day-to-day basis we purchase, usually the prices are within the range and affordable. But suddenly if you see a product with a very high price, okay, then naturally there is a question in the minds of the customers that what extra this offering is having, why there is so much increase in the price for such a convenience good? That is a question which pops into the minds of the customers. So, to mark the differentiation that something is different or unique in the offering, the product communicates that there is something different in the product. Customers' value perception. So, here with the pricing comes the value. Always the customer associates the price with the benefits and also the added values. That is the benefit. Now, here it may be with reference to functional aspect or the performance of the product, or it may be with reference to psychological value, psychological perception of the customers towards a particular offering. So, value in itself includes both these aspects, the functional aspects as well as the psychological aspect. Many a times we see that the customer perceive the pricing with reference to the value added to that offering. Now, coming to the next part is the factors that are influencing the pricing decisions. On what basis these prices are decided, or what are the factors which affect the pricing decisions? Now, here the first thing, the first important aspect is the pricing objectives. What are the pricing objectives of the company? Now, here the company takes into consideration the pricing objective with reference to the sales. That is, what would be the sales growth which it would be achieving in near future. Whether it wants to move slowly with a higher price into the market, or it wants to skim the market. Now, here again, the target market is important. Whether it's with reference to the particular region, that is, the regional marketing is taken into consideration, or on the national basis or international markets. It's entering the international markets. Now, here, whether increasing the profit is the objective or whether increasing the market share is the objective. Both the scenarios, they differ. If the company wants to increase the market share, then maybe it will think of decreasing the price and penetrate into the market. Or maybe if it is thinking of increasing the profits, it may have the higher prices and gain the revenues, or concentrate on gaining more profits. So that is the objective. If it's a new product, then basically the objective would be to enter into the market, make the people aware So initially it may price the product at a very, maybe on a lower side, when it enters, and then slowly it can increase the price. Now here many of them, they portray that the offering or the product is a status symbol. Now usually the goods with reference to luxury or fashion, they fall into this category. There is such conditions that need to think about the quality aspect and the segment when they are offering on a higher side. Now from the customer's perspective, they should satisfy the needs of the customer. That is the basic criteria. While taking the pricing objectives into consideration, affordability is one of the important things which they have to take into account. What are the prices of the competitors' products? And where our product is placed? Whether we would be fighting or striving for the market share, or maybe have something different in our product, keeping ourselves aloof from the competitor by offering certain unique feature in the product. Maybe catering to the mid segments by offering low price, or offering the quality product by moving ahead towards the leadership. So here, there are different objectives which the companies, they have to take into consideration. Element of marketing mix also play a important role. These factors, this is one of the important factor. Now, if you consider the first P, that is the product itself, if the ingredients, okay, the raw materials themselves are very costly, the company cannot think of coming down as far as the price is considered. Those products wherein the inputs, okay, the inputs which go into a product, they themselves are costly. The cost of the product would be at a higher side, naturally, and even the quality would be on a better side here. Now coming to the distribution channel. When we take this distribution channel into consideration, if we go for the traditional means, okay, that is from dealer to a retailer, then and then to the customer, then it would include a long chain and includes the margin to be given to the intermediaries, the middle people. Instead, if we think of a distribution channel like direct channels, that is a zero intermediary in between the company and the customers. In that case, one can think of offering the product at a lower price, even though the basic cost of the product may be on the higher side, but still, these margins are passed on to the customers. So they get the price product at a lower price. If we take the expenditure spent on the promotion, advertising, one of the most expensive part for the companies. Now, advertising is important to create the awareness. Of course, promotional activities are very much important when the product is new to the market. And the company spend a lot of revenues on this aspect. Now instead, suppose if people are aware about the product or the brand, it would, if it is a brand extension, then in that case, there is no need for aggressive marketing, aggressive promotion. So here the prices may be very less. So it depends upon these elements of marketing mix. As rightly just now I said, the basic cost of the product must be taken into consideration here. The differentiation is very important. The more unique in the product, the more would be the price, of course, but it should be of value from the customer's perception. The customer always thinks about the calculations, how much he is paying and return what the customer is getting. That's why somewhere this should be balanced. Again, the stage of PLC is also important factor. If the product is in the growth stage, growth market, the people are aware about the product, they start purchasing it frequently. In that scenario, more the demand, more the supplies, more the volumes, the company or the firm enjoys the economies of the scale. But against this, if it is in the introduction stage, the prices are higher because here there are more expenditures. As the per unit cost is higher, the promotional cost is also higher. So the average cost is on a higher side in the introduction stage. Again, in the maturity stage, if we see, the prices come down because there is more competition. People have a lot of choices. Their preferences now have changed. So here, this pricing attribute, it also depends upon the stage of the PLC of the product line. The type of product. Now here, which type of product it is. If you consider a product like petrol, okay, we cannot think of controlling the prices of petrol. They are governed, controlled. If it is a generic product, then there is a possibility that the prices may be on a lower side, on a medium side, but not on a higher side, too much higher side. If it is on a too much higher side, we come to know the segment. If it is a generic good, day-to-day basis we use it, the prices usually are on the lower side. If the product enjoys the USP, that is the differentiation, irrespective of the price, the people are ready to purchase it. So here we say, these are the special category products or shopping goods, in terms of shopping goods, where people, they don't mind spending. So which type of product category it is, price of the product depends upon it also. Now coming to the next very important factor, it's the demand. For the convenience goods, the demand is inelastic. There is no effect of increase of price because there are options available, there are substitutes available. But there are some products where, you know, the market is insensitive. Whatever is the price, the people are going to purchase the product. Irrespective of whether the prices, they rise or they come down. So this is about the demand part. The next is the government norms. Those are the categories of products where the government has a control on the pricing. The government decides the cap on the price factor. Here the manufacturer, the companies, they do not have much say in framing the pricing, in deciding the price of the product. The competitors also play a very important role in terms of pricing. If the product is at par with the competitor, one cannot think of increasing the price. If the company thinks of increasing the price, they are going to lose it to the competitors, the customers to the competitors. as I said, it's if it is on the lower side, the company is going to lose the revenues. So here there should be a balance while deciding the pricing. Now season is one of the important factors. This is as applicable for the seasonal goods, specifically when the demand is much high and it's a seasonal product, then the company thinks of gaining the revenues. Here again, it depends upon the competition. It depends upon the type of customers and the segments. If it's a rainy season now, you will see those goods where the demand is more, like umbrellas, raincoats, the demand is much high. Consumption of a tea or coffee. Maybe if it's summer, the reverse is there. Maybe the ice creams or the juices and all, the demand increases for such type of products. So it depends upon the seasonal, whether it's a seasonal type of product. And this is about the factors influencing pricing decisions. Now we move ahead with one of the very important point here in this, that is setting the price. Now here a firm must set a price for the first time when it develops a new product. It has to think about the price. What should be the price at which the product is offered to the customers? When it introduces its regular product into a new distribution channel or geographical area, it has to take these factors into consideration. It has to decide about its position, its quality, and the segment to which it is catering. Now we are the first and foremost point is selecting the price objective. Just now we discussed about this. That is, what would be the objective of the firm? Now here first and foremost think, where does the firm wants its product to be positioned? The more clear is the firm's decision with respect to segment, the more it would be helpful in deciding the end price. Now, for many companies, survival is the option. That is, if there are more competitors, these firms, they just want to survive in the market. If they have overcapacity or there is intense competition or changing customer preference, then profits become less important than survival. As long as the variable cost or some part of fixed cost are recovered, the company would like to stay in the business. Now, this survival is a short-term objective of the company. In the long-term scenario, it should add value or phase extension, that is liquidate the business. These are the options available. Maximize the current profit. If that is the objective, in that case, the estimate, the demand and the costs are associated with alternative prices and choose the price that produces maximum current profit, that is a cash flow or return on investment. Now, this strategy assumes that the firm has knowledge of its demand and cost functions. Actually, these are difficult to estimate or understand. Now, some companies would like to focus on increasing the market share. They believe that higher sales volume will lead to a lower unit cost and greater profits in the long run, which is true also. Now here for this, the following conditions should match basically. The first thing is that the market should be highly price sensitive for this. and a low price stimulates the market growth here. The second thing is production and distribution costs. They fall with the accumulated production experience. Now this I will explain you later what is this accumulated production experience in the next point further. The low price discourages actual and potential competition also here. Many companies would like to adopt the skimming strategy. They enter with the high price and gain profits. Now we have for this, there should be sufficient number of buyers with high demand. That is one thing. Second thing is the unit cost of producing a small volume should not be very high. Then the initial price, high initial price does not attract more competition to the market. And the fourth one is the high price communicates the image of the good quality product. Now against this, if it is a non-profit or a public organization, they may think of adopting other pricing objectives. The basic aim is the some recovery as far as the revenue is considered and serving the customers. That's why we say it's a non-profit organization. Whatever are the objectives of the organizations, the businesses use price as a very important strategic tool, which has an impact on the company's marketing objectives. Now, in normal case, you will find that this price and demand are related, both of them. In economics, you might have studied the law of demand, isn't it? That is the determining demand, price sensitivity. Now, demand and price are inversely related. The higher the price, the lower the demand, and vice versa. Now, in case of the premium goods, where prestige is an issue, the demand curve sometimes slopes upwards. If we consider the price sensitivity, now here if we consider the unique value effect, where the buyers are less price sensitive when the product is more distinctive. Suppose if it is a out of the box product, then the people are ready to pay a bit more extra to avail the features or facilities offered by that product. Against this, maybe against this, we can consider where they are not sensitive at all. Tomorrow, if the milk prices, if they go up, the people are going to purchase it. If the prices of edible oil, people are going to purchase it. Petrol, if we see, we don't have control over this. Goods, irrespective of the prices, we pay them, we purchase these products. Now here, number of forces like a deregulation or the price, instant price comparison. Now, because of the technology, the internet, because of the internet today, people come to know about the different prices offered by the competitors. It gives a ground to compare two offerings. That's why, again, for marketers, it has become a challenge today. As far as their offering is considered to differentiate and justify the price for that offering. So here, every now and then, they struggle to maintain the trade-off between these profits as well as the price and the differentiation which goes with this product or value offerings which are attached to the product. Now, estimating the demand curves. The companies attempt to measure the demand curves. The first and foremost part is the statistical analysis. They take into consideration the previous prices during the past, the quantity sold, and try to estimate the relationship in futures. Next is to conduct price experiments. Here they just try to conduct the experiments. If the price is less, what would be the reaction of the customers? They observe. If you increase a bit the price, what is the reaction of the customers? Whether they purchase the product, whether they don't purchase the product. That is, experiment is carried out. The third approach is directly to ask the buyers that with this proportion of units, how much they are going to pay. Now here the buyers might understate their purchase intentions at higher prices to discourage the company from setting higher prices. That is one of the drawback of this third method here. Now here, while considering this price demand relationship, the competitor, the market researcher must control the various factors that will influence the demand. Even the competitor's reaction may influence the price of the product. If the competitors comes up with an innovative product with low price, then that's a threat for the existing products in the market. So here the company should think about the competitor analysis as far as the pricing is considered. Now coming to the price elasticity of demand, the company should take into consideration the responsiveness part or the elasticity of demand in terms of price change. Now, demand is likely to be more less elastic in the following conditions, like if there are few substitutes or no substitutes, or there are no competitors for the offering, then the customers will have no choice in this case. So we say the demand would be less elastic. The buyers will have to purchase. The second scenario may be where the buyers, they don't realize that there is increase in the price and they continue to purchase the offering. Third scenario may be where the buyers are slow to change their buying habits and search for the lower prices. So there is such a segment of customers where they don't care much for the prices, with the change in the price. They are not critics. They come into this category. The price elasticity depends upon the magnitude and direction of the price change. It may be negligible with a small price change and substantial with a large price change. Now here it differs if you consider the increase in the price of a price cut with a small margin. Now the customers may try to continue the purchase in spite of increase in the price. Maybe they are satisfied with the intermediary, they are satisfied with the product. They don't have that much time to make an analysis of the increase in the price. here they are sticking to that product, they don't want to switch. So we say that they are habitual towards that particular product. Many of them, they don't want to change. So this is a psychological barrier. Now, in terms of estimating costs, you might have studied in accounts, you might have studied in finance. There are two types of cost, like fixed cost and the variable cost. So demand sets a ceiling on the price of the company for which it can charge. Now, what are the fixed cost? Hello. They are also known as overheads costs. A company must pay the bills each month for rent, heat, interest, salaries, and the other part is the variable cost. They are called variable because their total varies with the number of units produced. So total costs consist of the sum of the fixed and variable cost for any given level of production. Now, average cost is the cost per unit at that level of production. So here, whenever the company considers of costing, it takes into consideration the fixed cost, the variable cost, and then the marginal part. Now, coming to the accumulated production. So here, if you take an example of a company, maybe which produces units of any good, maybe it produces 100 units, okay, at a particular cost. The cost of maybe one unit is initially 10 rupees. Slowly and steadily, if we see, after a certain time, the people are well versed with the procedure, the machines are set, the hands-on experience are geared upon. So here, maybe after 2-3 months, when we calculate the per unit cost, it may be less than 10 rupees per unit, okay, and so on, maybe 9 rupees per unit further. So this part which I was discussing about the experience curve or learning curve, so this decline in the average cost with accumulated production experience is called as the experience curve or the learning curve. I told you that this I will discuss further. What is the learning curve? So with the experience, with the hands-on experience, the business systems get set. The suppliers, they also understand the customers. They are well-versed with the procedures. So here the systems are set, the processes are set, the production process is in flow. There are less hurdles as compared to the initial phase of production, which gives the advantage for this price factor. Maybe whatever are the units produced, they are at a faster rate, faster pace now as compared to the past. So this is what is known as the learning curve for the organization. But they also carry the major risk. Like aggressive pricing might give the product a cheap image. The strategy also assumes that competitors are weak and they are not willing to fight here. Now, this strategy leads the company into building more plans to meet demand. Maybe while the competitor thinks of introducing the new technology at a lower cost and penetrating into the market. So this might be the drawback. So most of the experience curve pricing, they have focused on manufacturing costs. But all of the costs, including the marketing one, are subject to learning improvements. Now here there is also differentiated marketing offers. Now in this cutthroat competition era, the companies are trying to think of innovative ideas of differentiation of products, differentiation with reference to distribution channels, with reference to the retailers, the retail chains. So here, as far as the costs are considered, it depends upon the retailers also, channel of distribution. Maybe a particular retailer may order on a day-to-day basis, while against this, there is other retailer who would purchase once in a week. So the company has to give more weightage to the retailer who is in contact on day-to-day basis. Ultimately also here, this tie-up or relationship between this retailer and the company will lead to further somewhere the pricing aspect, the profit aspect. Maybe both of them, they come in terms with reference to the discount part, the credit part, and the increase in the volume from the retailer side. So to estimate the real profitability of this dealing with the different retailers, the company or the manufacturer needs to take into consideration the activity-based cost as compared to the standard costing mechanism. This ABC accounting helps the companies to identify the customers which come into the different categories of this ABC. In production, we have the ABC analysis, the raw material. In the same way here also, in accounting, the company from the accounting perspective takes into consideration these retailers, the intermediaries, from that perspective. The next is the target costing. Now this cost change with production scale and experience. They can also change as a result of concentrated effort by companies, maybe designers, engineers, and purchasing agents to reduce them. They use market research to establish a new product's desired functions. They think of coming up with the new technological aspects. Then they determine the price at which this product will sell, given its appeal and competitors' prices. Now they deduct the desired profit margin from this price and leaves a target cost that they must achieve. Then they examine this cost. They break down it further into its further components. Now here the objective is to bring the final cost projections into the target cost here. If they don't succeed, they may decide against developing the new product because it will not sell then for that target price and make the target revenue. When they can think that they can succeed, then the profits are likely to follow here. So this is what is the target costing. Now the rest part, analyzing competitors' cost, prices and offers, that we will discuss in the next session. Now today we will stop here.